Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Chef D, and I'm here to give you the winning ingredients for your Thursday night football showdown between the Dallas Cowboys and the New Orleans Saints. Before we break that down, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MessNutsSD, and also sign up to the Patreon. You get DFS plays, you get betting advice. Everything is in this monthly package. Sign up now and do not miss out. Today's write-up, obviously, I got the Nets in here, KD, James Harden. I got the betting advice at the bottom. If you have questions with any of the plays, contact me on Instagram and I'll get right back to you. You don't have another subscription where you can get information and get a helpful advice, you know, at that moment, because a lot of these signups, you're paying $30 and you have questions, you have comments, anything. And there's no one there to help you. I'm there to help you, all right? Now, let's deep dive into this game between the Cowboys and the Saints. An injured Cowboys team getting a little bit more healthy. But on the other side, that Saints team is really, really struggling. A lot of QB problems. We're still waiting on Alvin Kamara and Mark Ingram news. So let's look at this injury report. Terrell Basham is trending towards playing. He's a very good DN that they have. Zeke is going to be a full go for Thursday. CeeDee Lamb coming back from that concussion. Back-to-back full participant in Monday and Tuesday practices. Cedric Wilson is looking like he's not going to play Thursday. So that can bring up another, you know, Noah Brown will be the number three wide receiver in that, because they still have CeeDee Lamb and they still have Michael Gallup. On the Saints side, Teron Armstead tackle looked like he's going to be out. Marcus Davenport, that's a hurt. It looked like he's going to be out. Caden Ellis. And we're waiting on news on Mark Ingram is trending, and Alvin Kamara is trending towards like he's going to play as well. He's been limited in back-to-back practices. Now, let's get into this slate, starting at the QB position, starting at the captain spot as well. We're going to go to Dak Prescott. You need some lineups with Dak Prescott. This is the key to the Dallas Cowboys offense. This is why they pay him so much money. Had a very good bounce-back performance against the Raiders. It was in a losing cost on Thanksgiving, but you saw some improvement. Two touchdowns, 375 yards passing, despite the fact that he had a lot of injured wide receivers. Now he's getting CeeDee Lamb back. So now it's CeeDee Lamb and Michael Gallup. That's a nice tandem. That should definitely be enough going up against the Saints, who really, really struggled against Buffalo, and they got torched on both sides of the ball. Dak Prescott can do a lot of similar things that Josh Allen can, and I think he can definitely exploit this defense, okay? Dak Prescott is going to be a top-tier captain, all right? Next guy we're going to talk about will be CeeDee Lamb. CeeDee Lamb, he's the number one wide receiver. If he's healthy, then we're going to play him. Look at the consistency against Atlanta, week 10, 6 for 94 and 2 TDs. Against Minnesota, 6 for 112. That's an outstanding performance. And then that performance against New England, that really was a big statement, because usually you know what Bill Belichick does to your number one asset. And CeeDee Lamb exploited them, 9 for 149 and 2 TDs. Now going up against Lattimore, Lattimore has been very up and down. I'm not going to be afraid to attack him. And you have two great plays here. You can either have CeeDee Lamb or you can even have Michael Gallup. Michael Gallup still doesn't have a TD yet this year. He's going to be high on my list as well. Obviously, with a little bit of less coverage from Lattimore, he should be the guy that should get open, all right? So we got a lot of Dallas here, a lot of gems here. And I still want to talk about Ezekiel Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott got a boost of confidence from the hierarchy. Jerry Jones, they're saying they're going to really give him a serious load. So that kind of talk makes me want to play Zeke as well. We're going to have to find value. We're going to really have to find value. A lot of coach speak, a lot of owner speak. Everything is trending good for the Dallas Cowboys to get things going, bounce back from that Raiders poor performance on Thanksgiving. And then, like I said, you have a very bad, struggling New Orleans Saints team that does not have a quarterback. They're really leaning towards Taysom Hill. If he is going to be a full participant in practice, then they're going to Peyton is going to give Taysom Hill the go as the QB. And that's going to be a lot of trickery, a lot of running plays, a lot of end around. It's going to be a lot of pleading and plotting, no big plays. Saints going to have to create some offense and some long drives. I don't know if they can do that against Dallas's defense. So if we do have to choose some Saints, obviously Taysom Hill is a jack of all trades. If he's going to get the start, even if he doesn't get the start, I think he's going to be used in a multiple facets. If he does get the start, he's going to be a QB. You see the rushing ability. They could do a lot of end arounds, like I said, or have him straight taking a snap and running up the middle. They could do a lot of creative things. Taysom Hill is going to be a very good play for Thursday, because I think they're going to lean towards playing him. So right here it says Coach Sean Payton Tuesday that the Saints will wait and see how his foot responds on Wednesday's practice, and then they'll make an announcement. I think that he's going to be in it. So we're going to put Taysom Hill in there. We're going to fade Travion. We're going to fade Trevor Siemian. And if they switch it around, then obviously we'll play Siemian instead of Hill. But I think they're going to lead with something more that gives him more options with the offense, okay? And Sean Payton's kind of struggled in the last past 2 weeks. He wants to change it up. Some other guys we're going to look at, and this will be the Tier 2 guys already. This is the Tier 1. We got Dak, we got CeeDee, we got Gallup, we got Zeke, and we have Taysom Hill. I know it's very, very Dallas-centric, but just looking at two teams on two different spectrums, one is at the top of the NFC, and one is at the bottom and struggling and trying to find their identity, okay? So that's why we're going to lean more to the Dallas Cowboys. So let's clear this out and go to the Tier 2, Tier 3 plays for Thursday. We're going to start that off with Tony Pollard. Tony Pollard is the number 2 running back for the Dallas Cowboys. Had a big, big performance against the Raiders. 10-36 rushing, 4 catches, 32 yards, and also had a kick return for a touchdown. This man is another jack-of-all-trades type of weapon that they have. Obviously, they were spelling Zeke, so you can definitely have just a little bit of Tony Pollard. I think this might be a Zeke week because of what Jerry Jones said, and that really, what he says means a lot. And Tony Pollard might just have one of his regular games like he did against Denver or Minnesota, but someone just to sprinkle in just in case. All right, next we're going to move on to Dalton Schultz. Dalton Schultz is one of the chain movers on the offense of the Dallas Cowboys. Very consistent target getter, 7 last week, 8 the week prior against Kansas City. I compare him to Dawson Knox a lot, but just a little bit less with the touchdowns. But just usage is there, just an extension of the running game. If he's 6 to 8 yards down the field, Dak Prescott loves to check it down to Dalton Schultz. So we'll go with him, obviously, as a Tier 2, Tier 3 type of play. That's a nice middle flex option. Michael Gallup, I spoke to you about him. I think the turnaround game is coming soon. I know I said it last week, and he had a good game. He had 5 receptions for 106 yards and 8 targets. Just didn't get in the end zone. That is coming. That is coming very, very soon, and it could be this week against the Saints. So we're going to keep him in there. Let's continue to go down. If they have Taysom Hill, you need to choose a wide receiver between Marquez Callaway and Tre'Quan Smith. For me, I think Tre'Quan Smith has been more consistent with both of these guys as backups, QBs. Tre'Quan Smith had the consistency with the targets from week 10 on, 7, 8, and 5. Marquez Callaway has been getting a lot of touchdowns. Not so lucky last week. He had a drop-off in receptions and targets. So he was really getting bailed out with those TDs. But Tre'Quan Smith has been the more consistent wide receiver option for the Saints. I'm going to go with him before I go with Marquez Callaway. Marquez Callaway would be the number 3 option in this offense, okay? At 6,400. Oh, I almost forgot. Before I even go, continue on, let me go to the captain and let's bring up Alvin Kamara. So Alvin Kamara is obviously a Tier 1 option. I apologize that I kind of skipped over him. That's because I saw the Q tag. So, guys, you got to pay attention. Like I said, he was limited in practice on Monday and Tuesday. You have to be vigilant. Wait and see until you get final news on Thursday morning when they realize, hey, Alvin Kamara is a go. then we'll have him as our tier one option. Okay, Alvin Kamara is obviously a tier one option if he is playing. All right, so those are the two guys you're going to focus on in the game with between Dallas and the Saints. You have your nice Dallas group of guys: Dak, CeeDee Lamb, Gallup, Zeke, and then on the other side you'll have Taysom Hill and you'll have Alvin Kamara. Okay, that's going to be tier one. Now let's continue on. If we can find some other plays, let's clear this out. Let's see if we can find some bottom end flex plays as we continue to go down this roster. Mark Ingram is the number two option as running back. If Alvin Kamara is out, then Mark Ingram would be the number one back. So we'll definitely have to put him in this type of game. As you saw with Alvin Kamara out, he was very, very productive. 16 attempts, 88 yards, 6 receptions, 25 yards receiving. He's someone definitely to look at if Alvin Kamara is out, okay? Or if you go, if you want to go double running backs, because you know how Taysom Hill's very, very limited. He might do a lot of stuff with the running backs. Check down here, check down there. Something similar to what you saw Washington did on Monday with Antonio Gibson and J.D. McKissic. That can be a very, very similar structure that Sean Payton does against the Dallas Cowboys. Get them a little bit rattled up, all right? So definitely is a great play, Mark Ingram. Let's continue to go down. Cedric Wilson is probably going to be out. Cowboys defense, Saints defense. We're going to fade both defenses. Kickers are going to be valid for both teams. Obviously, Taysom Hill, you don't really guarantee him or bank on him getting the ball into the end zone. It could be a nice, decent drive. They get to the 30 and they have to kick a field goal. Brett Maier is going to have to be a key guy for the Saints to knock in some field goals and keep this game close, because Saints do have a decent defense, just going off of prior years, but it's been a real struggle as of late. But if they're going to need to get some chip-in points, Brett Maier is going to have to be the guy. Greg DeLeg, we already know about him. Obviously, Dallas has an elite offense. They're going to move the ball up and down the field. He's definitely someone you need to look for if you just need, 8 to 12 points. Definitely Zerline can fit that in, okay? Let's continue to go down. If we're looking at tight ends for the New Orleans Saints, with the absence of Adam Trautman, Nick Vinette has popped up as the tight end, which is a shocker. Juwan Johnson is supposed to be the tight end. And then Nick Vinette has come in, made his season debut, and has been very consistent. Not very consistent, but is one catch in each game. And in one of the games, he had a touchdown. So that's promising to see. If you want to pick and choose between Juwan Johnson, Nick Vinette, and Garrett Griffin, I would lean to Nick Vinette, and then I would go to Juwan Johnson, all right, if I had choices, okay? Those are very ugly, ugly options, but it could be someone at the bottom of your lineup at the end of the flex, and you know how it could be a situation in the red zone, Taysom Hill, play action, and one of the, number two tight ends, number three tight ends gets the touchdown. Some of those weird type of scenarios that can happen. All right. Any other people that were looking at this cheap tree price down here? I did speak about Juwan Johnson. So those are the two tight end options for the Saints. And then other than that would be Noah Brown as the number three wide receiver if Cedric Wilson was out. And week 12, Thanksgiving, Noah Brown stepped in with 6 receptions and 9 targets for 53 yards, 11 fantasy points. Very, very good for the salary of $6. He almost 10 times that. He did a very great performance for what you paid for. All right. So if he's going to be the number three wide receiver, you see some consistency between him and Dak. Definitely someone you can put in at the bottom of your lineups and then build up the refs. So this is a value spot right here. I gave you two value guys here, Noah Brown, and you can choose one of the two tight ends on the Saints, okay, between Vinette and Juwan Johnson. All right, thank you guys for tuning in. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MessNessJetsD, and I'll be back with a video very, very soon. Another one, all right? Peace out, guys.